Good evening. Welcome to Anna Kappa's commencement ceremony for the class of 2013 and all school awards ceremony. My name is Susie Seeke. Yeah. My name is Susie Seeke. I'm head of faculty, and I'm going to be your mistress of ceremonies for the evening. And I'm also married to the headmaster. In fact, tonight is our 44th wedding anniversary. So we decided to throw a party, and we're so glad you could all come. Okay. I want to ask you to make sure that you turn off your cell phones or put them on mute right now so that they won't interrupt the ceremony. And I did want to let you know that we are going to try and move this along in a very expeditious way so that you can all make your dinner reservations and not have to compete with all the university graduates that are out there doing the same thing. First thing I'm going to do is introduce David Gore, who is the president of the board of directors for Anna Kappa School. Please welcome David.
Well, thank you, everybody. I'm one of those late arrivers here, and I'd like to congratulate all of the other late arrivals who managed to find the same creative spots in the parking lot next door to us that I did. Congratulations once again to all of you who managed to do well in that regard. Thank you, Susie. On behalf of the Board of Trustees for the Anna Kappa School, I particularly congratulate the class of 2013 for their many accomplishments. For their many accomplishments during their years at the school, and add my welcome to all who are here with us this evening. Not only do I lead meetings of the school's Board of Trustees, I've also been here in the audience in years past as proud dad of Amanda and Edward as well. Thanks to Amanda and her husband Eric, we have a 4-year-old grandchild now, Charlie. With luck, I won't be here on the stage. I'll be there sitting in the audience along with you as I watch the class of 2027 graduate. Based on the efforts of everyone here in attendance, the students, faculty members, family members, staff, and many friends of the school, it's been a great year for the Anna Kappa School. And though we've encountered a few obstacles along the way and didn't meet every goal we set for ourselves, the Anna Kappa Board of Trustees worked productively behind the scenes to ensure the school's long-term health. We'll always have challenges ahead of us. We never lose sight, however, of our fundamental values to do what's right and to do it well. Anna Kappa uniquely provides a challenging college preparatory curriculum. We develop the powers of objective reasoning and independent thinking in all of our students. We encourage strong bonds among classmates and teachers. And we maintain a safe, caring, and supportive environment. You know these things now, and you'll remember them even more in the years ahead. It's now time to hear from Headmaster Gordon Seeke, but before that, again, on behalf of the entire Board of Trustees, let me offer a great round of applause and congratulations for the class of 2013.
All right, I'm on a short leash, 3 minutes, so did we get this thing moved along? So I want to get right to some important thank yous and just really focus on some thank yous that I think are really important to make right now. And first of all, thank you, Susie, for being a part of the school for the last 32 years. This is the 32nd completed school year. And it's had its challenges for us, and we've also benefited absolutely greatly from the opportunities to learn along with the students and be a part of something so amazingly attractive as the Anna Kappa School. All right, thanks. I'm going to shout out a few. I want to thank our 7 international students. This is our first, This is the founding program, founding year for the international student program that the board and I and worked on to create and to launch, and it took a number of years to actually launch it. And so we have Jehan from Korea, we have Alan from China, we have Paulina from Germany, Oriane from Switzerland, Felipe from Brazil, Isabel from Germany, and Tommy from Argentina. How about that for the first year for some real diversity? All right. I'd like to thank our band. There's a lot of things that I could do, but I'm going to really stay on this schedule here and just kind of limit it. I want to thank our band, the Adobes, for their incredible music, in particular the veterans, Isaac on drums, Isai on bass, Sam on keyboards, our amazing vocalists, Odalis and Cassidy, and of course their wonderful teacher, Ugo. Thank you very much, Adobes. I'd like to thank the Anacapa Near Space Exploration Club, AKA ANSEC, for bringing so much to the school this year, including 2 astronauts, Rick Lenihan, who flew in from Houston for our synthesis unit, the most amazing man, just tremendous opportunity to connect with Rick, 5 shuttle missions, a vet, a Navy fighter pilot, and a shuttle astronaut. Also, more recently, Chris Cassidy on the International Space Station, where we got to ask him questions for 10 minutes. And I really want to thank NASA. They've been so generous to this school because we have presented them with proposals that were so attractive that they couldn't do anything other than be generous to the Anacapa School, and they certainly were. And so I want to thank NASA. I want to thank all of our generous donors for your financial support, the annual giving program, and the auction. Without your support, we wouldn't be the diverse school that we are today, that provides so many scholarships for our wonderfully diverse student body that reflects the community that we live in. I want to give special thanks to the faculty for not only being superb teachers, but also for being creative problem solvers. And we do have problems that we need to solve. So thank you guys for being there through all that challenging moments. And I want to really put a big personal shout out to Dr. Robert Eberhardt, my co-founder, who provided the philosophy for this school, deserves all the credit for the philosophy that has guided the school for the last 32 years. I want to also thank our administrative team, Sharon, Susanna, Susie, and Becca, for putting this ceremony together. Thank you all for being here.
I would like to recognize, are there any other board members besides David in the audience that I should recognize here? I think David might be the only one, but it's a good thing because we're full, huh? So we didn't have room for him anyway. We are, the first award this evening is the Jessica Bauer Award, and that's for our Student Volunteer of the Year. And I need to get one card, so hold on 1 second. Thank you for your patience. This year, some of you who are more closely involved with the school might know that Anacapa does not have a mandatory volunteer requirement. So the students volunteer, they get out into the community or help at school, but they do it on a purely volunteer basis, and it's become really a part of the culture of the school to do that. This year, it was so challenging to discover who was going to be our Jessica Bauer Award winner that we chose 2. And because both of these students have given more than 150 hours each over the course of this year, as in school, as ambassadors for potential students that come to visit, in admissions, from hosting open houses, farmers market, independent school night. They also help on dances, auction help. We have them fill out a form that says what different activities there were possibilities during the school year. And these two students had to check almost every one of them. One of the students that were doing this also was a special host for 4 weeks for the international students, making sure that those students were very comfortable, and plus put in countless hours on the movie project that you'll probably see at the beginning of next year. The other student outside of school has been volunteering at the Sea Center, at Santa Barbara Museum of Art camp, and was a cabin leader twice. So these students just exemplify what Jessica Bauer, the namesake for this award, represented and started all for us. You make us very proud, and we want to thank you, Rufus O'Day and Amelia Artuzio. At this point, I'd like to recognize parents. So all Anna Kappa parents, past and present, let's just go for you all. Go ahead and stand up, would you, so we could give you a round of applause. You're very important in this. All Anna Kappa parents. Thank you for sharing your wonderful students with us. This next part on the program, if you're following along there, for honor rolls, is also going to let you have a chance to see some of the up-and-coming students, even some seventh graders, because the honor roll that we have is going to be their honor roll as well. And the teachers weren't supposed to tell what kind of grades they got on their finals and everything, so it should be a surprise for most of them. We have three levels of honor roll at Anna Kappa. We have cum laude, which is a 3.0 to 3.49, and that's where I'm going to start. So I know it'll be really hard, but do you think you can hold your applause until they all get up here? Yeah, you can. Come on, try. Okay, so we're going to start with Felipe Bernardes. Oh. That was tough there. Come on up. Hazel Brady, Nicole Francia, Henry Johnston, Isaac Macario, Leah Millar, Matthew Nunez, Noah Nidham, there's a seventh grader for you, Rufus O'Day, you just saw him, Ryan Reich, here's Felipe. Thank you, hang on, I got more. Jahan Rowe, here, Gordon. Give those to Gordon. Randy Ross, Alex Sherwin, Wyatt Taylor, Diego Villarreal, Natalie Whiting, and Bronson Whitney. Come on down. Here's a Bronson. As David Gore said, that it is a challenging academic college preparatory. These guys had to work hard to get these grades, right? Congratulations, you guys. Nice work. Yay. That was a 15-minute training. The next level of honor roll is magna cum laude. These students have earned a 3.5 to a 3.99. and the envelope is heavy. Are we ready? Oh my gosh, I feel so bad. Claire, is Claire here? We'll put her in this one. It was from the last one. It was from the last level. I'm so sorry. Okay, so here we go. Somebody else want to do this? No. Patrick Alcero, Alexander Dalbati, Odalis Gonzalez, Zinia Gonzalez, Della Hatfield. Hold on to this. Jen Hatfield. He's done. Cassidy Hessian. Raymond Johnson. Timmy Johnson. Lottie Johnston. Anya Ledner. I better not leave any off this time, huh? Ezai Macario. Asia Mayrock. Isabel Montefour. Orion Peter. Allie Powell, Neva Pradham, Sam Robertson, more, Shayna Smith, Ethan Steiner, Grace Strelich, Kiara Trujillo, and Alan Zheng. Shayna. Oh, Shayna. Ethan, he must be around Sam.
Steiner.
All right, a round of applause for these students. These scholars. Congratulations. All right. Nice work. At Anna Kappa. We don't weight grades, which means that the maximum that a student can earn is a 4.0. The following students have earned a 4.0. Elena Alcero. Emilia Artuzia. Hayden Brooke. Joshua Colahan. Daisy Gonzalez, Laura Kostruba, and Jade Mueller Galbraith.
Go, Daisy.
Let Jade get in there. Congratulations. Excellent. Really impressive. We do have to cap it at 4.0, yeah. While they're getting seated, could I recognize grandparents, please? All the grandparents that are in the audience, could you stand up for a moment so we can recognize you? You're sure important to the lives of the students. Yes. Yes. It's really wonderful to have you here. Thank you for coming. We're going to give academic achievement awards right now. That means that I need all the wonderful faculty up here on stage. Get up here. What?
First, okay. Hi, I'm Sally Eve. I'm the performing arts teacher. And this year, I'm going to give two awards, one for the first semester and one for the second semester. Because each semester, we do a different performance, and I want to make sure that the hard work of the first semester gets acknowledged. So, first semester, we did a concert on the history of American music with Ugo's music class. And this student who's going to get the award took the initiative to really try to find music suggestions to contribute to the class. Would send me emails, listen to this, send me YouTube links, I guess they're called, I don't know, to watch people, different bands perform. And I really appreciated that this person kind of took ownership of the performance and contributed this to the class. So in appreciation for enthusiasm, great attitude, and teaching me some music that I didn't know about, and I really appreciate. The first semester Performing Arts Award goes to Rufus O'Day. Okay, second semester, we did a play called The Little Mermaid. And as I say every year when I'm up here, and I always say to my class, putting on a play is teamwork, takes an ensemble. There's no one person that makes a production work. Everybody has to work in order to put on a good production. That being said, and we had some challenges this year, and I just want to give a shout out to my whole class and thank them, because they handled those challenges wonderfully, better than me sometimes, and I really do appreciate it. The award I'm going to give out for this semester goes to a student who, every time they came to class, gave me 100% in rehearsal. Now, you may think big deal, but that is a big deal, because most times actors go, I'll do it right in rehearsal, I'll do it right in performance, you know, and I have to wait until they get in front of an audience to really see what they can do. And that makes me nervous sometimes, because I don't know if they're going to do the right thing. But this student always gave me 100%. And so in appreciation for an incredibly great attitude, a lot of energy, being a role model for the other students on how to practice, and also being a pretty killer Jamaican accent, this award's going to Laura Kostruba. Nope, go stand up here and I'll go stand.
Okay, so I'm Levi Maya. I teach the Digital Voyage Media Studio course at Anna Kappa. And this year, I had a tremendous group of really creative students. And so it was difficult to pick one that really stood out. But I had one student in particular who came to the filmmaking class without any experience using a digital film editing equipment. And at the beginning, he was a little nervous about it. And by the end of the year, he was not only a proficient, but a fantastic editor and Final Cut Pro, and also had really honed his screenwriting abilities. Unfortunately, he couldn't be here with us tonight, but the Digital Voyage Award this year goes to Sam Bernstein. I've also had the privilege and honor of working with the Anna Kappa Near Space Exploration Club for the past 3 years. First 2 years, we sent up high-altitude balloons into near space, got some tremendous pictures and video. Last year's recipient of this Academic Achievement Award was Julio Bernal, who is this year's team captain. He's going to present this year's award to one of the ANSEC 3 team members.
Hi, good afternoon. So, like Levi said, I was last year's recipient, and this year's recipient is, despite not knowing English so well, she passed her ham radio license with flying colors, and I'll be quick about it because Susie says we're rushed. So, Orion Peter.
Hi there. I got the memo, so I will be quick. My name is Paula Campanelli, and I'm the ceramics arts teacher, and although we have many talented students in ceramics, I could only choose one. So this year, the award goes to a student who I feel has learned and appreciated the art of ceramics craftsmanship, creativity, and design, and she is also, as a student, very focused, respectful, and very kind. She'll be leaving us this year, but she will keep her little sister here. So once again, Xenia Gonzalez.
Hello. I'm Megan Neslin, and I teach the biology class. And for the biology award this year, I couldn't really decide. I had two students that were just the top of the class. They got the two top overall grades, which means they had stellar test scores, they had thoughtful labs, and they had near-perfect homework records. And also, both of these students sought outside opportunities in biology-related things. So my two biology awards this year go to Cassie Hessian and Amelia Artuzio.
Hello everyone, my name is John Luca. I teach geometry, physics, and calculus. As I like to say, teach the easy stuff. Anyway, so we had great classes this year. The first, I'll start with calculus. I want to acknowledge every student in the class. They generated a great environment. It was very challenging, a lot of fun, a lot of hard work, and the student who I think really excelled in that class was Alan Zhang. And he is on his way to China right now. So, and he has his award, but calculus, Alan Zhang. So. And also, as I said, I get to teach geometry, and that's a pretty fascinating class as far as I'm concerned. And again, a great class, a tremendous amount of work, a lot of challenge, a lot of creativity, overcoming a lot of frustration. And as a teacher, there's nothing more rewarding than to see a student apply themselves consistently, overcome challenges, and really get to a place where they just really excel at the material. And a lot of students did a tremendous amount of great work. But this year's Achievement Award in Geometry goes to Neva. And then finally, in physics, We did some pretty wild stuff in physics. You know, one thing you can do at Anna Kappa is you can go places where you might not ordinarily. So we were able to spend a good bit of time discussing relativity theory and time slowing down and just crazy ideas from quantum mechanics with things being in two places at once. And again, just a phenomenal class, real interesting questions, just thought-provoking investigations. But the one student who, in my mind, really, really grabbed, I was going to say gravitated to the material, it's a kind of physics thing, was Patrick Alcero.
Hi, I'm Hugo Macario. I'm the Spanish and music teacher. So to be a great musician, it requires soul, passion, dedication, and talent. This student possesses all these qualities. No matter where or what instrument he has on his hands, he's always spreading joy of music. And probably you already know who it is, Sam Robertson. And the door to success is opened by having these key characteristics: commitment, discipline, and work ethic. This student goes above and beyond all expectations. Besides putting a lot of effort in the schoolwork, she balances it with hard work training outside of the school. And the recipient is Ali Powell.
Peggy Lauer, and I teach English to many, many of your students, and I'm giving out the award for excellence in literature. The recipient of this award came to us as a seventh grader from Cesar Chavez with a really good background in spelling and grammar and punctuation. She had all that down by the time she was a seventh grader, and as time progressed, her writing got more mature, more elegant, more sophisticated, and really was writing by the end of this year college-level essays. As the years went on, I began to realize that she had turned into the TA for her classmates, and that she would read their papers ahead of time and give them feedback and proofread for them. And they were often reluctant to turn in their papers before this student had had a chance to work them over. So invariably prepared, invariably ready to answer questions, invariably serious, quiet, and studious. This award goes to Zinia Gonzalez.
I'm Allison Strelich. I teach eighth grade literature and the photography class that just got started up again at Anna Kappa. This award goes to a person with innate creative talent, technical knowledge, and a willingness to experiment that makes the photo gods smile every time. I gave this student a 2-year-long assignment And this person took it up without batting an eye. And the other thing I want to say about this student, this student has become a really prolific printer in the dark room, very comfortable in the dark room now. We do have a dark room. It's just off the men's bathroom. If you haven't seen it, come by. It's adorable. The student has become really good at printing in the dark room, but told me that she wouldn't feel a complete person until she'd gotten the art of developing film down. So this award goes to the very complete Emilia Artuzio.
I have the wonderful opportunity to teach studio art and Italian. And I'm going to start with the award for Italian. The student is always interested, always ready to learn, remarkably consistent effort, and in the past year, noticeable progress, which makes a teacher smile, including the student has learned to roll his R's. So Rufus. Thank you. All right. For studio art, I had a student who is super eager to learn as well, all year long, every project. Each artist of the 102 that we studied. The student was incredibly thorough and diligent regarding the classwork. Wrote an essay on Caravaggio for the final that shows excellent, outstanding understanding of all the components of visual art and how they can be used to express the artist's passion. So my first art award goes to Asia Maybach. Sure, this is yours, babe, but if it's not, I'll switch. Okay. And you'll understand. I needed to give another one. So, quickly, this student was naturally talented, which comes in handy when you're doing art. Naturally talented, but with a conscientious attention to detail that was unequaled in the class. Numerous excellent projects, including a beautiful, beautiful chair and a super job as a docent for our Lac Mateur, Bronson Whitney. Congratulations.
Hello, everyone. I'm Brian Anderson, and I teach math and a few other things. But tonight I'm presenting the math award. And this student, it's always ready to learn as soon as class starts. It's always prepared with homework, asks great questions, isn't satisfied with not knowing. And that impresses me. Each day is just the same, no difference in her days of the week. And it goes to a repeat offender up here, Allie Powell.
I just can't resist one comment regarding Bronson. I had the opportunity to be in his and Henry's group, and my family in Florence are a dynasty of art guides and historians and art historians in Florence. And Yeah, there's a future for you, Bronson. I tell you right now, I can see it. All right, history. I have the privilege of teaching history to all the students and have for all these years. And it's a tradition in the school for the last final to be an oral final, an oral presentation. And this was World History II, so we had a lot of interesting topics over the last few years. I had some very high, five extremely high scores. I always take the highest one regardless, and that is the person that receives a history award. And there were so many excellent presentations, and it was very hard. But when the numbers, when I crunched the numbers, then there was one winner. But I do want to acknowledge Jen's amazing job on death penalty, Orion's UN, Asia's gun violence, Sam Robertson's Israel-Palestinian conflict, and Kiara did an amazing job on same-sex marriage. The winner looked at refugees in the world and did an absolutely amazing job of looking at refugee status and the state of refugees in the world, and some of the famous refugees in history, such as Einstein and Anne Frank and others. Henry Johnson.
It's awfully fun working with such a great group of students. These students came from parents, and we have a wonderful group of parents that we get to work with as well. Each year we give a parent outstanding service award, and this year the parent recipient, I'd like to tell you a little bit about this parent. Incredible people skills. You will always feel comfortable with this parent. Parent has shared photos and smiles for the last 6 years, not to mention behind the scenes support, including cleanup after almost every event, offering intern and volunteer opportunities to our Anacapa students, and being very involved in every auction. This year, she stepped in to handle a notoriously challenging aspect of the auction, and she really made it seem easy. The tough thing is that her students are graduating, but the great thing is that she promises to continue to help. So please welcome Lucy Macario. Yeah.
Everybody can. Well, I think just when I say that I'm here representing everybody, is this honor is because I know Anacapa always, parents always are involved. So this is in behalf of all the parents. Thank you so much.
The very nice thing about Anacapa is once you're Anacapa and you understand what we're working towards, then you stay very connected. And we have a very nice group of alums, and there's a lot of them in attendance this evening. So if we could have alum students and faculty please stand so we could acknowledge you. Yeah. It's absolutely wonderful to have you here. I know it means so much to the students, but it means a lot to us as well, the teachers. So, Gordon, you get to do some of the really fun stuff now, seniors with seniority.
All right. Well, as some of you know, we started out as Anacapa High School in 1981, and I taught 5th and 6th grade for Goleta for 11 years before I had the opportunity to get involved in starting the school. And I really like working with younger kids, but I really wanted to work with high school kids. And at a certain point, I decided really that we needed to add in the 7th and 8th grade, and that was 1990 when we did that. And we became the Anacapa School. And really my goal there was to be, have a safe place for students to be for all 6 years, not to have to go to the junior high and then the high school or the vice versa. And it's been an amazing, 6 years goes by so quickly. It's hard to believe how quickly it goes. But to be able to work with students in the 7th and 8th grade level is just a kick. I just love them. It's just so much fun. And to see them grow into high school students and stay with the school all the way through. So we're especially rich year this year with the seniors with seniority. We have 5 of the 7 graduating seniors. Patrick, Julio, Zinya, Esai, and Isaac. Thank you. I get 5 minutes for this? Wow. Okay, so I'm going to slide something in before I give the Spirit of Anacapa Award. Just something that's been on my mind, and like I said, I'm on a pretty short leash, which is good. But it's been going through my mind really quite a bit. As the founding head of Anacapa School, I can tell you I was pretty naive as a young headmaster, thinking what the school would be and what kind of kids would come to the school. And I had to learn the hard way, and it was an evolution for me. One of the things I really wanted to see from, you know, early on in the school was that the school would be diverse, that we would have students that would come from Latino community. And primarily, you know, we don't have an African American community of great numbers here. It would be nice to see that breakthrough sometime. But it really took a long time to have Latino students coming into the Anacapa School. And the way it happened, it really started like back in 2002 with, you know, Alicia and some of the big names in the alumni student body, and it slowly grew. And it really didn't grow because I made it happen. It happened because people saw the school as a place for the brightest young Latino students in these various schools, such as Franklin School, Cesar Chavez, Cleveland School. Teachers basically bringing students to open houses because they wanted to see their brightest kids get the kind of education Anacapa offered. So that's how it started, you know, and it kind of moved along with Sonia, and then the board got involved and offered 2 full scholarships, and Dylan and Brenda Renteria received those, and it just kind of slowly moved along. And now what we have is a truly diverse school that reflects the Santa Barbara community of great students and great families. And what we're also happening now is that little sisters are coming in, cousins are coming in. And because we've earned the trust of the Latino community that we're going to take good care of their students and give them a great education, that means a lot to me. It took a long time, like 25 years, whatever it was. It took a really long time to break through. So I needed to say that, and it also references the Spirit of Anna Kappa Award, as you will see momentarily. We're going to do something. We're going to do something we've never done before. Wow. All right. We have seven seniors. This class has stayed together. As Susie says, they're not showboats. They don't have big egos. Not a drama. There really is not much drama, and drama happens in the high school. I'll tell you, it does. And just not much drama. They do their job. They work together. They're team players. And I just got to say that, you know, I started thinking, well, because I'm the one that ultimately decides this award. I get to do what I want sometimes. So I couldn't choose. So I chose the whole class. Get up here, you guys. Is a very strong class, and we're very, very proud of you, and thank you for all the service you've done to the school, and your get letter, you're leaving a really big legacy. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So we have something really fun now that will entertain you all. We're going to have our slideshow. So you guys put down your awards and go get your costumes on. We're going to have a slideshow of our trip that we just took to Los Angeles for 4 days. We just got back Wednesday. And thank you to Ethan Steiner and all the people that gave presents. Yeah. We have a wonderful slideshow, so I'm going to get the screen down, turn the lights down, and I hope you enjoy it.
Don't forget we're no real king in Boston, San Bernardino.
Oh, my. Let's
Well, I'm really looking forward to this and hearing their speeches. Our students speak for themselves. We don't have a commencement address speaker or a valedictorian. All of our students speak for themselves, and that's the tradition of the school. I really love the job of being involved with this community and this school and students like we have. In order to do it, I have kind of a crazy exercise early morning routine, and I want to do this job a bunch more years. So it's I'm out there pounding the pavement or on the trails or wherever very early in the morning. So I'd like to share a little bit of my morning this morning in reference to what I believe an ANACAPA graduate is. I was going up Painted Cave Road at my absolutely most favorite place, complete starlit, unbelievable Milky Way. The Corona Borealis, the Northern Crown, was sitting right in the Milky Way, and I was thinking, it just came. And I had, of course, the trusty machine. And so I was trying to think, what makes an ANACAPA graduate? So all of you alums out there and future alums out there, what makes an ANACAPA graduate? So this was about 2 minutes, and I think it gets to the core of what an ANACAPA graduate is and what these students certainly are. Aren't afraid to get off the beaten track to come to our small school and take a new trail. Look people in the eye. Be kind. Be trusted and have integrity. Have high aspirations. Be creative. Out-of-the-box thinker. Be able to work on a team. Care about our world. Someone you would like to live next to. Resourceful, resilient, determined. Understand the power of I will. The class of 2013 has all of these qualities and more. Now it's your turn to speak. Patrick Alcero.
Okay, so I've sat where you guys are plenty of times now that you just kind of want to go to dinner, no matter how much you enjoy listening to us speak for a long time, so I'll try to keep it short. After 6 years at ANACAPA, there are a lot of memories and many people to thank. From our first trip to Zion National Park to sleeping in the bus in Death Valley to avoid the wind, we've had some great times and made some close friends. My most memorable trip was last summer to Italy with Gordon and Susie, so thank you for that. The teachers at ANACAPA are unlike any others. Thank you, Peggy, for teaching me to write a good paper, and to my dad for many hours, often late at night, of proofreading and support. Hopefully you won't have to do that much more. Thanks to John for making physics fun, and to Megan for putting up with me in marine bio. Chemistry was a much more enjoyable subject. To Brian and Ugo for the fun times both in and out of the classroom. Thanks to Susie for 2 great years of art class. And thank you, Gordon, for your enthusiastic and in-depth lessons on history and politics. I'd like to thank Levi especially for allowing me to pursue my passion for film and letting me create my own projects. At ANACAPA, I've experienced nothing but encouragement. Encouragement to pursue my dream as a filmmaker. I've never encountered one person here who has ever expressed a moment's doubt that I would succeed. So a huge thank you to Gordon and Susie, Sharon and Dwayne, Levi and Daniela for giving up the last 3 Super Bowl Sundays to come to the 10-10-10 Film Festival to support me. And to Dave and Pam at Dejan Productions, thanks for giving me an internship and teaching me so much. To all of my friends, classmates, and teachers, thank you for believing in me. I would, of course, also like to thank my family, my aunts, uncles, and cousins for always being there for pretty much every celebration. To my grandparents, who have been to every performance, every show, every birthday, every event, and you have never wavered in your faith in me. I love you all so much. To my sister Elena, you were right last week when you said it wasn't as bad as we thought it would be going to the same small school. I might actually miss you next year. Might. To my parents, all I can say is thanks, although you deserve so much more. for the books upon books you guys read to me for literature, because I'm not very good at reading, and for staying up late with me, even though you didn't have to, to make sure I finished an assignment and to keep me company late at night while I rushed to finish films for the 10-10-10. For your love and support and for allowing me to attend Anna Kappa, thank you. I cannot thank all of my friends that I've made over the last 6 years because it would take too long and be too hard to say goodbye. So to all those I have not mentioned, thank you. I will miss you all next year when I attend Loyola Marymount to study film. Thanks.
ACE Mike Cario.
Good evening. So when I first thought about my graduation speech, it was at the beginning of the school year, and I pictured myself bawling my eyes out as I told all of you how much I would miss my brother when we'd go off to different colleges. But luckily, we're attending the same college, so you don't have to see me go through that. So my time here at Anna Kappa has been a great experience. Throughout my 6 years here, I have grown intellectually and I've grown to be a better person. Firstly, I would like to thank Gordon and Susie for accepting me into the school 6 years ago. I personally would like to thank Susie for being my advisor throughout the most critical part of my high school career. As your advisee, I never wanted to disappoint you. Also, I wanted to thank you for never doubting my academic abilities and for always making sure I did my best. And thank you to all the teachers as well. I would like to thank my parents for the infinite amount of support they have given me. Dad, you've been more than just a father. You've been a best friend. I've been fortunate to be able to spend most of our summers together since we have practically the same schedule. And I've learned a lot from you. You always took me to play soccer and played music with me and encouraged me. And I've been really lucky to spend so much time with you, and you've shaped me into the person I am today. Mom, you're an amazing woman. Not only did you succeed in raising two twin boys, but you have managed to expand your education as well. In May, my mom graduated from SBCC with honors and achieved an associate's degree in early childhood education. You're a role model to follow. Your academic achievements inspire me to work hard and achieve great things in the future. The immense love and support you have shown me will forever be appreciated. Thanks to you, I am ready for my next adventure in college. I love you so much. Isaac, you've been by my side since before we were born in this world. You are my best friend. We have done almost everything together, and I'm glad we get to continue our lives together for 4 more years. I think having a twin brother is one of the best things anyone can have because we will always be companions for life. As Terry Guillemette said, there's no other love like the love for a brother, and there's no other love like the love from a brother. And those are words I truly believe in, because I love you so much, and I will forever cherish our childhood memories. I will never forget the sometimes rough personal competitions about being the better twin. But in the end, a winner can never be decided because we are so similar. I'm glad we will both be heading off to the same college, and we could both help each other in achieving our goals. Xenia, you've been a very special person in my life. You always brighten my day every time I came to school. It makes me sad that I won't get to see you every day when we go our separate ways. We've laughed together, cried together, and we've created wonderful memories that I will always remember. I know you will do great things in your future because you're smart, beautiful, and committed. You have those characteristics that will make you successful. I love you so much, and you will always be in my heart. To my fellow classmates, I know you all can be successful in the future, and I wish you luck in your new adventures. Thank you all who attended the ceremony tonight. It means a lot to me and my classmates. Like the great singer Héctor Lavoe said, todo tiene su final. Everything has its end. But with the end comes a new beginning, and I'm excited to begin a new adventure in college. Thank you.
Sorry, I'm short. So these past 6 years at Amna Kappa have prepared me mentally for what's to come next after graduation. However, nothing can ever truly prepare someone emotionally. So this is how it is. Now that I've reached this major transition in my short life, I've realized how much I truly appreciate my parents and my loved ones. Throughout my life, I've been blessed with amazing teachers who have always supported me and been there. Before attending Amna Kappa, I attended Cesar Chavez Charter School. It was here that I met my teacher, Ms. Rodriguez, who is an amazing inspiration and a wonderful role model. I'd like to thank her for always believing in me and for always having the mentality of si se puede. In addition to Ms. Rodriguez, I had Mr. Molny, who always encouraged us to be different. I began my seventh grade year at Amna Kappa because of both of their support. Upon my arrival at Amna Kappa, I've been impacted by an array of teachers who have each helped me grow as a person in their own unique way. In particular, I'd like to thank Brian Anderson, who has been my advisor and teacher since my seventh grade year. Throughout this time, Brian has stood by me and encouraged me as I struggled to get through school some days. He was always there with a smile, willing to listen to my crazy stories. I know for a fact that he will continue to brighten the students and faculty's days at Amna Kappa, and I will always be your flower. To Gordon and Susie, I cannot thank you enough for welcoming me into the Amna Kappa family, not only once, but twice. As I reach the end of my time here at Amna Kappa, I look back on all the wonderful memories I have created with my friends and classmates. I couldn't have asked for a better senior class. The memories we have built together will last a lifetime. True friends are hard to come by, but I'm lucky enough to have found many true friends here at Amna Kappa. Julio, Isaac, Shayna, Matthew, and Odalis, each of you have impacted my life by being such wonderful people, and I will miss you all dearly next year. Kiara, we have a unique bond since we're the only two girls in our class. I'm going to miss your amicable and clumsy personality. Brenda and Sophie, I don't know how I managed to get through this year while you two were away. The two of you are my best friends I could ever ask for. Isai, we've had our ups and downs, but I will always cherish the memories we have built together. You've always been there for me no matter what. You're such an amazing person, and I will always be there for you. And I know you will be successful in whatever you choose to do. I love you so much. Growing up, family has always been very important to me, so not having my family close by next year will be a very challenging thing for me to do. Oscar, you're the best big brother I could ever ask for. I love you so much. You've helped me grow up through these years and have always told me to go after my dreams no matter what. Daisy, you are the sassiest, craziest, sweetest, and best little sister ever. I know I don't tell you this very often, but I do love you, so just know that. And I will miss your quirky personality. I can never thank you enough for encouraging me to take a chance and to go away for college. Most importantly, I'd like to thank my parents. Queridos padres, les quiero agradecer por su apoyo y por todos los sacrificios que han hecho para que tenga un mejor futuro. I'm sorry. Los quiero mucho y los voy a extrañar mucho el año siguiente. My parents have always have always and will continue to be my inspiration. As I start the next chapter in my life, I will use the morals and life skills they have taught me in order to build my future. As we close this chapter in our lives, we are opening the door to a new beginning with numerous possibilities. It is up to us to choose our own path. Along the way, we're going to make mistakes, a lot of them, but that's okay because those mistakes are the ones that will help us grow and eventually will lead us to success. In the words of Winston Churchill, success is not final, failure is not fatal, it is the courage to continue that counts. Thank you.
Kiara.
Hi. Okay. First off, I would like to thank Gordon for allowing me to be a part of the Anna Kappa School. Even though it took many meetings and convincings, you made me come to my senses and showed me this was a school for me. I would also like to thank the faculty and staff for supporting me throughout the years. Sharon for dealing with all my college requirements and always being up to date on what we need. Ugo for being an awesome synthesis group leader. Megan for being the most amazing science teacher and making science exciting. Paula for showing me my creative side to ceramics, and Sally for teaching me the art of jewelry. But there are a few special teachers that have devoted a lot of their time for me. Peggy, thank you for all the time and help you put into me. You were always so generous and willing to revise and help me with my essays, not just for your class, but for my college essays and outside of school assignments. You always did it with a smile on your face, even if it was last minute. I'm sorry. Susie, thank you for being such an amazing advisor and Italian teacher. You made me the student I am today. You never gave up on me and always acknowledged my potential as a student. Without your love and encouragement, I would not have the confidence to succeed. Mille grazie, ti voglio bene. Brian, thank you for your patience and time to get to know me inside and out. Not only have you taught me math, but life lessons. I'm going to miss you making math class fun with our off-topic conversations about life. And you being my nurse on every trip, medicating me whenever I was sick, which was all the time. You are like a second father to me. I would especially like to thank my family and friends for supporting me throughout these years. From the friends I have known since elementary school to the new ones I have made here at Anna Kappa. Zinnia, I am so happy you have been a part of my class for these last 4 years. We have made every moment special and have so many memories to treasure. I love you so much and can't believe our high school days are over. I couldn't have asked for a better best friend to graduate with. Shayna, thank you for being such an amazing friend. Even though I've known you for less than 2 years, I feel like I've known you forever. It's going to be different next year without you in any of my classes, but I will definitely treasure every moment that we had. I love you, Shay Shay, you are my sister. My parents for all their sacrifice and hard work they have done for my education. Papi, tú siempre me has enseñado a seguir mis sueños y siempre será tu niña chiquita. Mami, no sabes cuánto te quiero. Todo lo que haces por mí, sé que sacrificias mucho por ponerme adelante. Y te lo agradezco mucho. Espero hacerlos feliz como ustedes me han hecho feliz. Dylan, thank you for being the best big brother anyone could ever ask for. You have taught me to shoot for my goals in the very best possible way. You never lacked to look out for me and protect me. I hope one day I can accomplish my goals and dream big like you. Piero, you are the sweetest little brother ever. Although at times it seems like I hate you, I really don't. I love you and I'm so proud of you already. Last but not least, I would like to thank my fellow classmates for making these past school years so amazing. I have developed true friendships and memories with you all, and I can't believe we have made it this far. Thank you and congratulations to the class of 2013.
Isaac Lucario.
Well, since I've been here since seventh grade, I remember sitting in the crowd and seeing all the other seniors graduate and thinking to myself, well, I still have 6 years left. I don't have to be up here and give this talk. Because when I came to Anna Kappa as a seventh grader, I was a shy kid. I wouldn't talk much. I was terrified of public speaking. And this idea of speaking in front of everybody just was the scariest thing for me. And the school has really helped me change that. I've really grown as a person. I've grown into a school leader by joining the Senate, which was something I never thought I would do. And I thank Gordon and Susie for that, for letting me come here. Gordon, I always loved your history class, even though sometimes we never agreed on certain certain topics. And Susie, Italian class was always one of my favorites, especially because we cooked once a week, and that's where I developed my passion to cook. And Brian, you've been my advisor since I was a little kid in seventh grade. And I just want to thank you for always believing in me. I know I wasn't the smartest, but like, and I was kind of lazy too. But you always like, but you always told me to you. You always told me to put the maximum effort I could, and I thank you for that. Mom, here. You're an example. Mom, I thank you for setting an example by showing me what you can accomplish with education. This year you graduated from SBCC, and I was very proud of you. I just saw how happy you were after you graduated, and I just felt really proud, and it made me want to further my education as you have, and never stop learning as you've never stopped learning, even though it took you a long time to get that degree. Dad, you've been my best friend. You've taught me so much, from soccer to music, which are two things that I actually love. You've always been my coach and would always tell me where I could improve after every game. And again, getting back to my laziness, I wasn't too fond of exercising, even though I'm considered an athlete, but I was kind of lazy. And my dad, he also showed me what could be accomplished with fitness. As he tried raising my level, I always had music around my life, my dad being a musician. I always had instruments laying around the house, and my dad never pressured me into playing an instrument, but it just came naturally to me, and I never really settled on an instrument. I was kind of bouncing around for many years. I tried the violin, I played the trumpet, and then ultimately I settled on the drums when the Anacapa band needed a drummer. And I had never played drums before. It just kind of came naturally to me. And my dad, I didn't have like a lot of confidence doing this, but my dad, he kept believing in me. And he would help me out when I couldn't get a rhythm down and I would frustrate myself. And I thank you for that. Sai, you've been my best friend since day one. And we've been through so much together. I'm happy we're gonna go to the same school. One of my fears this year was parting ways with Isai, and that thought just terrified me because we've always done everything together, whether it be sports. We generally like the same things. And although we will be going to the same school, we will be taking different paths, and I'm proud of what you have accomplished, and I love you very much. Thank you.
Julio Bernal.
Congratulations, Julio.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Yes, man.
So, first of all, I want to say, dang, it's been a long, long, but really short 6 years, and they've been amazing, filled with insane memories that I will always cherish forever. I just, first of all, I want to say thanks to Gordon and Susie for accepting me into a wonderful school. Even though I, you know, at first I was just like, oh my God, I don't want to be here. It's going to suck. No offense, guys, but it's been great, and I will never forget this school. Second, I want to thank Brian for always being one of my best buds. You know, we grew up together all the time, midnight snacks on school trips. We share crackers. It's amazing. You've been a great friend, Brian. Thank you. Peggy, I also want to say thank you to you because when I first came here, I was very, how do I say it? My writing, let's just put it like this, my writing improved a lot. So thank you for that, Peggy. Megan, I just want to apologize for all those headaches and just annoyances that I did during class. I know I'm out there and I'm outrageous and stuff like that, so I'm really sorry, Megan, but thank you for those awesome biology classes and chemistry classes. And John, I'm really gonna miss you. I know we only had, we had two classes, but it's only been 1 year. But you were a great inspiration for me. You really pushed me. You yelled at me a lot, but I didn't mind that because that's the way I learned. you know, but it's been great. Thank you for everything. Levi, I want to say thank you to you as well because we've had our, you know, share of great laughs, great memories. ANSEC's been amazing. You've sort of molded me into what I really want to do in the future, so thank you. And I want to say thank you to my parents, mamá, gracias por todo. Oh my God. I don't want to cry, so. Gracias por todo, mamá. Te quiero mucho. Te voy a extrañar muchísimo los años que vienen. Tu comida. Tus abrazos en las mañanas. Cuando me regañas. Todo. Todo lo voy a extrañar. Papá. Tú has sido una gran persona para mí. Muchos días, aunque no estuvieras en la casa, ya sabía por qué, porque siempre trabajabas para tener la comida en la casa y para tener una vida muy feliz. Y se agradece todo lo que has hecho por mí y por nuestra familia. Gracias. Adriana, aunque seas guerrosa, enojona y todo, aunque me grites, me pegues, siempre te voy a querer. Y aunque te grite yo también y te la regrese, siempre serás mi hermanita. Y siempre te voy a querer. Y gracias por todo lo que has hecho. Por mí también. Finalmente, mis amigos. I want to end off with you guys because we started off on a really, you know, kind of loose end. But over the years, we've come together as classmates. And I consider you guys my closest friends. So thank you for all the memories and all those great times. Thank you.
Our illustrious Tribune, Henry Johnston.
Henry Johnston's end of the year speech. These past few years have been great. The amount of knowledge I have acquired in class or outside class has and will help me in future years. I would like to thank the teachers at Anacapa School and the students as well. Thank you all, and I hope to see you soon again. Maybe it will be here or out in the real world. Over the years, Anacapa has changed, and so have I. And as a school, we have experienced so much about the world around us. We are given slices of life that we can learn from, and these experiences will help us out. During the past few years, I have developed my filmmaking practices and will remember Anacapa as I continue to make films. I would like to thank the doctors and therapists that have also helped me greatly. I wouldn't be here if I didn't have such wonderful parents. And lastly, I would like to thank my dad and my mom for putting me through this school and helping me out every step of the way. Thank you so much. And to all the future 12th graders out there, watch out. It comes fast, and when it's here, you won't even realize.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the awesome class of 2013.